وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. This inshallah ta'ala is our fifth episode and our fourth lesson. In this lesson inshallah ta'ala, or this episode, I want to inshallah ta'ala talk about adhkar al-sawm, the remembrance and the dua and the supplication that we need to be doing in the month of Ramadan. Inshallah ta'ala, there are four main du'as that we should be making in Ramadan. There are four main du'a that we should be memorizing. We should be making sure that we make them in the month of Ramadan. The first one is, ماذا تقول إذا رأيت الهلال? What do you say if you see the crescent? You say, الله أكبر. اللهم علينا بالأمن والإيمان والسلامة والإسلام والتوفيق لما يحب ويرضى أما لما تحب وترضى ربنا وربك الله. The person says, if he sees the crescent, الله أكبر. Oh Allah, you are great. اللهم أو الله, we ask you, علينا بالأمن والإيمان والسلامة والإسلام, we ask you for faith, we ask you for safety, we ask you for peace, and we ask you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Islam. We ask you to give us the ability to do that which is pleasing to you and that which you love. Rabbuna, our Lord, O Allah. Wa rabbuka Allahu, and your Lord, Allahu Azza wa Jalla. Everyone else, their Lord. The second dua that you need to be making is, what do you say عند الإفطار, when you're breaking your iftar? You say, ذهب الظمأ, the thirst has gone. وابتلت العروق, and the arteries are moist. وثبت الأجر, and the reward has become established. Inshallah, if Allah wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do you say? إذا أفطرت عند قوم, if you break your fast at someone's place, and they invite you to break your iftar at their place, what do you say? You say, أفطر عندكم الصائمون, the people who are fasting have broken their fast in your gathering, in your house. وَأَكَلَ طَعَامَكُمُ الْأَبْرَارِ, and your food has been eaten by the righteous. وَصَلَّتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, and the angels have supplicated for you. The fourth dua that you need to be learning and studying and making sure you memorize is what you would be saying, إِذَا عَلِمْتَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ, if you know that the Laylatul Qadr has entered. The dua that you need to be making is, Allahumma, oh Allah, innaka afuwun, you are one that forgives. Tuhibbu al-afwa, you love forgiveness. Fa'fu anni, oh Allah, forgive me. Forgive me for my shortcomings, my errors, my mistakes. You should be saying that dua. These four supplications are important and vital that you memorize them, that you learn them, in order for you to be making it when you are in these situations. The first one is when you cite the crescent, the dua that you need to be making. When you are breaking your iftar, the dua that you need to be making. When you are at the gathering or at someone's house and you're breaking your iftar in their house, the dua that you need to be making. And last but not least, if there's a high speculation to you that Laylatul Qadr is entered, and this night isn't the night of Laylatul Qadr, then you make this dua that the Prophet taught, alayhi salatu wasalam, to our mother Aisha, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us and give us the strength and the ability to be able to remember to say these dua and memorize these dua. I hope, inshallah ta'ala, that you write it down and you memorize it before Ramadan enters. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.